some organisations that were just doing fabulous work with exactly the same funding as organisations who were just doing the bare minimum. And they're both being equally valued and judged as equally good. And yet this first organisation was just doing so much more. And actually, there wasn't any way of demonstrating that value, and there wasn't any way of showing that you could just do more interesting stuff. You could do something that would bring additional benefit to communities. And at the moment, commissioners of health care, primarily, it's not they're not ambitious, but they cannot see the possibilities out there. And it's only when you get a dialogue between commissioners, providers and communities that you really get a co-created, co-developed sense about, so what could we do together that would make a difference? So the people who fund healthcare will never be as creative as the people who use or deliver them, because they absolutely understand what they want, what their personal ambition is. And I will always be more personally ambitious for my health than any commissioner would be. At the moment, what happens is the health system determines the priorities and then tells communities what it has and hasn't to do. And that's created a huge passivity. And now, of course, everyone's wondering why people won't give up smoking and why they won't. It's because the priorities aren't ones that the communities own, and yet it's their money. So the only way to generate priorities that make sense is to do it with communities. But that means they do have different priorities than health systems usually have. They do have a different sense about what they want to do and how they want to do it, and they have a different pace of change. And that means health, and what happens is health providers get irritated by that and just say, oh, for goodness sake, they don't really know what they're doing, and you know, we could do it a lot faster. But actually, you never do it faster if you don't work with the people who are using your services. So the reason why I'm saying this is that unless you design services with users, you will always have wasted value. The only way of generating true value is to do it with your users and communities. What we know from complex systems is that you can't always tell the unintended consequence of anything you're doing. So if you just measure your intended impact, it doesn't measure all the other stuff that happens. And also, you sometimes miss some of the really great unintended consequences. So what we suggest is that you have to measure lots. And when you've measured lots, you start looking for the patterns and the correlations between all that stuff that you've measured and say, what can you see here that shows you the value that you're adding that you may not have expected to. Social value is created when people have decided together what they want to do, because everyone then commits resources, personal resources to it. You know that saying, you own what you create. This process means that in the beginning you have to agree your intent. What do you want to create together? And after you've done all the measuring, you're then saying, did we do what we wanted to do? And together you're reviewing how you're going to change it, and together you're signing up and committing to making more effective change together. And that's the piece that's really different. That brings in a phenomenal amount of additional capacity into the system.